Welcome to American Popular Song Today, changing the way you listen to music. Every week, Teddy and I give you the tools to hear more in the songs you love. First, important dietary news. After consuming all that cake for the celebration of the 20th episode last week, I have been eating salads every day all week. Okay, no I haven't, but I meant to. Thank you for keeping me honest. This week we're in part two of our three-part series, How Songs Tell Their Stories. Let's waste no time, hit it! Last time we talked about songs that spill the beans right away, that tell their story right up front and then repeat that story again and again, even when the music and lyrics change. Because songs like that repeatedly circle through the same narrative, I call them circular songs. But other songs, like the songs we're going to talk about today, tell their stories not all at once, but bit by bit. The narrative continues to advance and unfold throughout the song. Because the story is always moving forward, I call these forward songs. To get an idea of what this sounds like, let's take a classic example of a forward song, The Gambler by Kenny Rogers. You'll notice that unlike in a circular song where things basically stay the same the whole time, in a forward song, new things keep happening. In The Gambler, the story begins with two guys sitting on a train in silence, but by the end, vices will have been indulged, wise words will have been spoken, and someone's gonna die. Kenny begins the number by dramatically setting the scene.
On a warm summer's evening, on a train bound for nowhere, I met up with a gambler.
Now that the scene is set, things will begin to happen, moving the story forward as the song progresses. First, the gambler breaks the silence.
The boredom overtook us. And he began to speak.
He talks for a while, and then makes Kenny an offer.
For a taste of your whiskey, I'll give you some advice.
Kenny gives the gambler a drink, and the gambler drinks it.
So I handed him my bottle, and he drank down my last swallow.
Then he gives the gambler a cigarette.
Then he bummed a cigarette. Ask me for a light.
Then the mood changes and the gambler puts on his poker face.
And the night got deathly quiet. And his face lost all expression.
It's like Kenny is sitting around a campfire giving detail after detail about the action. Now that the gambler has broken the silence, had his drink, had his cigarette, and prepared his face, he imparts his famous advice.
You got to know when to hold up. Know when to fold up. Know when to walk away, know when to run.
Let's acknowledge that we've already heard a lot more story than we typically would in a circular song, but Kenny's not done. No, no, no.
When he'd finished speaking, he turned back toward the window, crushed out his cigarette, faded off to sleep.
Listen to those wonderful verbs moving the story forward. He finished, he turned, he crushed, he faded. Even though we're deep into the second verse, we still don't know the whole story. Not yet. Not till one last thing happens. Spoiler alert! I guess I spoiled it earlier. Having imparted his wisdom to Kenny, the gambler dies.
Then somewhere in the darkness, gambler, he broke even.
And Kenny finishes the song by remembering the gambler's wise words.
In his final words, I found an ace that I could keep. You got to know when to hold up.
We kind of take it for granted, but it's absolutely incredible that the same medium that gives us songs like Rock Around the Clock, that really go nowhere, also gives us songs in which a character who's alive at the beginning might die before our eyes in the course of the number. That's the type of thing that can't happen if the story is stuck in one place. But that's the whole point of a forward song. Forward songs allow for development, for change, even jarring surprises. Let's take a famous example of that. A forward song by the Beatles, the classic Norwegian Wood.
I once had a girl, or should I say, she once had me.
Norwegian Wood tells the story of a man who goes home with a woman thinking he's gonna get lucky. The story unfolds bit by bit, line by line, ever forward. One of the first things we learn about the woman described in the song is that she has her own place and the walls are decorated with Norwegian pinewood paneling. As the song goes on, the story continues. They talk late into the night, and when 2 a.m. rolls around, she tells him it's bedtime.
We talked
Wink, wink. Very exciting. But then, almost mocking him for thinking he's gonna sleep with her, she laughs and says she's gotta get up for work in the morning. The story continues to move forward. When the man wakes up in the morning, the woman has already left. Finally, in the last line of the song, shocking twist, to get revenge on her for not sleeping with him, he sets fire to her apartment. You think they're gonna hook up, then they don't, then it ends with a felony! Unbelievably good. By the way, 10 points to that woman for not sleeping with that guy. If you ever find yourself in a situation where the options are sex or arson, run! Anyway, the thing to notice here is that the story takes the whole song to tell. You can contrast it with what Norwegian Wood would sound like if it were written as a circular song, with the whole story right up front. In fact, it would be pretty easy to rewrite Norwegian Wood as a circular song. The first verse would say something like, I thought I was gonna get lucky, but the girl said no. Then there would be a chorus or a refrain saying something like, yeah, I set her apartment on fire, the Norwegian Wood made the flames go higher. That's the whole story, and in a circular song, we would know all that pretty fast. Then it would circle through the story again. We would get a second verse saying how she said she had to work, how he slept in the tub, and then go back to that chorus or refrain saying, yeah, I set the apartment on fire. There might even be a bridge saying, that's what you get for rejecting me, before going into the final chorus of, yes, I set the apartment on fire, the Norwegian Wood made the flames go higher. But John Lennon didn't write Norwegian Wood as a circular song. He wrote it as one long story, building, turning, moving forward all the time, and ending with that unexpected twist. Now, last week I said that circular songs were amazing because they defy our natural instinct to allow the story to move forward. The flip side of that is that forward songs are so great precisely because they satisfy our natural desire to see the story progress. By unfolding over the course of the song, forward songs unleash tremendous storytelling power. They take us on a journey with the potential for surprises, changing emotions, and new situations. As you're listening to songs this week, pay attention to whether the story is moving in little circles or unfolding throughout the song. One way to think of it is like this. A circular song will answer the one-word question, what? But a forward song will answer the two-word question, then what? Of course, there's a third question corresponding to a third type of song, but we'll talk about that next time. In the meantime, what are your favorite forward songs? Put them in the comments. We'd love to know what you're listening to. That's it for this week. We'll see you next time. And don't forget to subscribe. Subscribing makes you feel good inside. So don't forget to subscribe to our channel and like the American Popular Song Today Facebook page.